them out stronger. Indeed, I celebrate the Bokoa for his physical discipline. For his physical discipline, I'm not bringing stats in human capital development, infrastructure renewal, technical and professional education, as well as peace and unity. It will be the honor of you to give a faith to also acknowledge the role played by the founding father of the state, much the state from Peter's.
Watch your back.
Go without saying that the state flourished under the current democratic dispensation of the Ghana and the United States. In this regard, Your Excellency, Chief Justice of the Supreme Court, and Dr. Emmanuel, the waiter of life, deserve special commendation for their vision and tenacity of purpose. Today marks the beginning not only of a new conversation, but of an era where we advance, let us say, the greater heights, the people-centered policies, human capital development, and infrastructure. It will have been achieved by the immediate past administration. The new government is going to advance the state through the more agenda, which stands for meaningful development, opportunities for all, realistic reform, enhanced peace. The new administration will seek to foster sustainable economic growth and private sector domination. Boost human capital, build and enabling infrastructure, enhance governance and community systems for improved service delivery and strengthen public financial management. In front of these objectives, the existing technology development group to be sustained and expanded to encourage the creation of small businesses, fostering jobs, and consequently reducing crime and social activities among our members in the population. We will also enhance the existing social investment programs for the benefit of the poor and vulnerable groups, including windows and people living with disabilities through microcredit, training, and business network. We shall follow the growth empowerment program for women and sexual, particularly in the greater community. This administration will ensure the construction of all ongoing projects, roads, bridges, schools, and other physical infrastructure. As you all know, government and public. Hence, we shall build a conducive development for public private partnership investments in mentally more sectors of the government. In the agricultural sector, we shall develop the agricultural value chain, which is a major driver of sustainable economic growth. This administration will spend all effort to ensure and the development of agricultural parks as related, giving their intention to generate employment, create wealth, reduce unemployment, and improve food security. The recent approval of the Nigerian Export Processing Zone Authority from the Bureau of Parliament is a welcome development because these projects have the capacity to unleash the growth potential for the state. With the board already in place, we shall continue to take steps to make it fully operational and attract investors to the zone. Death has been very peaceful in the last 8 years. However, recent security breaches in the Warri area are troubling. This administration, the aid of security agencies, will take decisive steps to ensure that the situation does not degrade. today. In addition, merit will be the last for innovation in the government position to encourage health into and retention of the best grade in the public sector. Furthermore, this association will render all necessary support to the judiciary. To enable it carry out its functions without less or hindrance. Your Excellencies, my dear people of the United States, the issues that confront this administration are not new. They are about improving the quality of life for people, about bringing issues of social cohesion, about giving our people the hope of a better tomorrow, and about assisted development. And it demands creative thinking, proactive action, and exemplary leadership from me and all those who we have the privilege to serve as elected officials and political appointees. I pledge to run a global and a positive government amidst the needs and aspirations of our people, and present consolidation and advancement. Consolidation because I'm continuing from where the previous government is coming. An advancement because I'm advancing better through greater investment in inclusive money growth, human capital development, infrastructure renewal, and peace and security. I am committed to making life richer, better, and more fulfilling for our people. To my colleagues in the 6th Assembly and 7th Assembly, I wholeheartedly thank you for your support. My appreciation also goes to the fathers of faith for your prayers and support. And to our beloved regional leaders, thank you for your prayers, words of wisdom and advice. I will continue to count on you for your support. In conclusion, I give up the prayers of all of you for the wisdom to lead and the divine enablement to achieve the goals that we have set for this administration. Tasks to face are tough, choices are not easy, but with your support, our prayers, we shall again become strong. God bless the better things. God bless your life. unified. The lion of the tribe of Open. To once again step forward to dismiss the parade. It is now my privilege and honor to respectfully invite His Excellency to perform that duty. Your Excellency, sir. Now put our hands together and may we rise as he's coming down. He's going to dismiss the parade mountain. That is the duty of the governor and it has started today. So he's going to dismiss the parade. We are waiting for His Excellency. Honorable Chairman of the Kepo Okuma, thank you to your pleasure of the state. Honorable Dennis is at the role, Chief Putin Jaffe, Ezine Nela, Badi Ebrego. I, Chief Pate, Jeke, my brother, Wilson Mama, and in Mecca, all of you, from home, I'd like to welcome all of you.
Our governor.
Okay.
Zero, She doesn't care about the resistance.
She's got a fist in the gun.
Yeah. Thank you.